Please do be seated. Before the ceremony begins, may I ask please that if you have a mobile telephone that you switch it off now or switch it to silent so as not to disturb those around you. As secretary and clerk, it is my privilege and pleasure to welcome you to this evening's graduation ceremony. Graduation ceremonies follow a tradition that began in the 15th century, and that tradition has evolved since. Roughly translated, graduation means taking a step, and it symbolizes the move of the former student, now called a graduand, into a new role in wider society as a graduate, there to use the talents developed as a member of this society. Each graduand will cross the stage and shake hands with the Vice Chancellor to symbolize their transition to this new role, and we will applaud them for their success so far and in anticipation of their contribution to society in future. At the end of the ceremony, the Vice Chancellor will formally admit all those who have crossed the stage, indicating that each and every graduate is now incorporated into the community of scholars. As new members of this community, as the academic procession leaves the stage, the new graduates will join the procession, and that will conclude the proceedings. It is now time to begin our formal proceedings, and so I hereby declare the ceremony to be in session. And I call upon the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Michael Thorne, to come to address you. Vice Chancellor.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted to welcome you all here today to join in this special day, a day in which we celebrate your achievements, the class of 2014. For most of us, graduation is a once-in-a-lifetime experience, so we do hope you'll enjoy it. But perhaps those here today whom it will most please are those who have supported you during your studies. Parents, partners, children, and friends. To all of you, we say, we couldn't have done it without you. Thank you for your part in our success. Those of you graduating today certainly made the right choice in choosing Anglia Ruskin University for your degree. The latest official statistics show that more than 9 out of 10 of last year's graduates were in work or further study within 6 months of leaving us, and that we rank in the top third of universities for graduates earning more than £25,000 a year. Thank you. In the National Student Survey, you expressed record levels of satisfaction with your courses and placed us in the top 20% of UK universities for lecturers who are good at explaining things and who make their subjects interesting. And we recently heard the news that we've been shortlisted for the award of UK Entrepreneurial University of the Year. Thank you. In order to give you a taste of how successful Anglia Ruskin students have been this year, let me start with sport coaching student Danny Williams, who won a judo gold medal at the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow in July this year. Thank you. 4 other Anglia Ruskin students are current UK university champions in their sport. The prestigious Macmillan Prize for Children's Picture Book Illustration has been won for the 5th year in succession by one of our students, Bethan Woolvin, and Anglia Ruskin students also took the 2nd and 3rd prizes. Aisha Guido received the Community Award from the Cavell Nurses Trust, and Julian Penner, an international business student, and his team saw off competition from more than 250 other teams from universities from over 60 countries to win the 2014 Peak Time Awards in Riga. Thank you. We have 8 officially world-leading research areas. They are allied health professions and studies, geography and environmental studies, social work and social policy and administration, psychology, English language and literature, history, art and design, and music. This December, we shall hear from the government whether our application for world-leading research status for a further 7 academic subjects has been successful, an application which itself demonstrated that research here has doubled in the last few years. It goes without saying, therefore, that our academic staff and their researchers and research students have also enjoyed a very successful year. Professor Jamie Hacker-Hughes has been named as the new president of the British Psychological Society. Dr. Debbie Holly has been made a National Teaching Fellow, the most prestigious national award for excellence in higher education teaching. Professor Amelia Oldfield became the first ever recipient of the World Federation of Music Therapy's Clinical Impact Award. Liam Kite has been named Lecturer of the Year by the Association of Optometrists. The Global Resource Observatory, the most ambitious project to map the world's resources in over 40 years, has been launched by our Global Sustainability Institute to help governments worldwide plan better. Jukka-Pekka Haikala has been awarded a prestigious Newton Fellowship, jointly by the British Academy and Royal Society, so that he can work with us on research into entrepreneurship in East Asia. The one single piece of research which attracted more interest from the world's press than any other, and which I might add was published in a highly prestigious research journal, was our finding that those people who have sex four times a week are likely to be wealthier than others. Our postgraduate medical institute now offers 5 master's degrees in surgery. Mr. Adam Howard, senior lecturer in minimally invasive and robotic surgery, successfully carried out a new type of life-saving keyhole surgery, believed to be the first of its kind in the world, to deal with a dangerous weakness in the wall of a vein in an 83-year-old man from Truro in Cornwall. Professor Tony Young, urological surgeon and professor of medical innovation, has been made the first ever National Clinical Director for Innovation with NHS England. The largest ever analysis of worldwide vision impairment and blindness data has been led by Professor Rupert Bourne of our Vision and Eye Research Unit and published in the Lancet Global Health Journal. Sarah Redsell, Professor of Primary and Public Health, is working on a Medical Research Council funded project with Cambridge University and the Universities of Nottingham and Lincoln on the proactive assessment of obesity risk during infancy. Professor Helen O'Dell Miller is working on a National Institute for Health Research funded investigation into whether music therapy improves social interaction and communication in children and adolescents with autism spectrum disorders. Professor James Hampton Till is working with Basildon and Thurrock University NHS Foundation Trust to examine cardiovascular outcomes for people using different anticoagulation strategies. Taken all together, these projects represent more than £1 million of medical research funding across all 5 of our faculties. We continue to invest in new buildings. Work is now underway on phase 2 of a new building for our Faculty of Health, Social Care and Education in Cambridge, and here in Chelmsford, the Anglia Ruskin Business Innovation Centre for Medical and Advanced Engineering, the MedBIC, was finished at Easter. And we continue to invest in sport, not least through the £5 million redevelopment of our sports ground in Cambridge. The range of companies for whom we deliver degrees in the workplace has grown this year to include the Institute of Export, Specsavers, UPS, Harrods, Volvo, Wilmot Dixon, Barclays Bank, the Army, Navy and Air Force, the Port of Tilbury and Tamdown Triconics. Our subsidiary, Ixion Holdings, has successfully enabled more than 4,000 people to leave long-term unemployment and start their own successful businesses, as have more than 5% of our graduating students. This year has also seen the launch of our very popular university mascot, Ruskin the Rhino. Ruskin has proved to be a big hit with students and was named by the Evening News as one of Cambridge's 8 most prominent figures, alongside the likes of Stephen Fry and Geoffrey Archer. Now, before I close, I should like to take this opportunity to thank members of the boards of governors of Anglia Ruskin University and our partner LSM for their unstinting support and advice. But most importantly of all, I want to take this opportunity to offer my deepest thanks to the staff, all the staff of Anglia Ruskin University and LSM, each of whom, directly or indirectly, has made an enormous contribution to your success. Everyone here today owes them a huge debt of gratitude, and I think we should show our appreciation in the usual way. Finally, to all of you receiving degrees, diplomas, and certificates today, if you enjoy the occasion, there is a way of repeating this once-in-a-lifetime experience. Study for an even higher level degree. No matter what, you have a lifetime of learning ahead of you. You join a long line of distinguished alumni, which includes Chan Abraham, CEO of the Luminous Group, Oliver Baines of Blake, who won Best New Album in the Classical Brits Awards and are now celebrating having sold more than 500,000 albums. Lynn Berry, former CEO of the WRVS. Manish Basin, who covers sport for the BBC. Charles Clark, former chair of the Association of Chief Police Officers. TV presenter Nick Crane of Coast, Mapman, and Great British Journeys. Their honours, Judge Margaret Fawcett and Judge Howard Kemp. Alexandra Pringle, editor-in-chief at the Bloomsbury Press. And Mark Wood, who moved from deputy chairman of the commercial giant Paternoster to become CEO of the NSPCC. We're very proud of you. Best wishes for your future careers wherever they take you. Do please keep in touch with us. Anglia Ruskin University and LSM would not be the exciting, vibrant, and ambitious academic communities that they are today without you. Thank you.
We now come to the presentation of those receiving awards this evening to the Vice-Chancellor. And I call upon Pro Vice-Chancellor and Dean Dr. Gary Packham to read the names of those who will be presented from the Lord Ashcroft International Business School. Dr. Packham.
Vice-Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present to you students from the London School of Marketing. For the award of Master of Arts, Marketing and Innovation, Atia Ijaz Tahir. Mohammed Navid Asif. For the award of Master of Business Administration, Sonia. Syed Abdullah. Chamli Prasa Abwatha Hedwedji. Faisal Abbas. Mohammed Zain Abbas. Kasif Abbasi. Mohammed Ikubakan Abdul Majid. Mohammed Jonal Abidan. Radhika Adhikari. Hasib Ahmed. Nisir Ahmed. Sajad Ahmed. Waka Ahmed. Tahura Ahmed. Mohammed Ahmed Azuziman. Fatir Ajaz. Abdullah Hamad Al Fayyad Al Hajari. Iktika Ali. Mohammed Ryan Ali. Shamshad Ali. Mohammed Sharia R.S. Al-Kaibi. Abdullah Mubarak S.B. Al-Kairain. Farhad Ali S.A. Al-Mahari. Mohammed Nazim Uddin Al-Masood. Muna Tarum Omran Tarum Al Shami. Mohammed Abu Ambia. Gurpreet Kaur Anya. Naheed Ajum. Mohammed Imatez Ahmed Ansari. Mahesh Gangadhar Amnumela. Mohammed Soabib Arif. Mohammed Arang Saib Ashad. Salman Arshad. Bilal Asal Shima. Mohammed Asaduala. Cuba Asgar. Mohammed Asif. Mohammed Adil Farzan Ali. Ilham Aslam. Baraka Sanjaya. Ayesh. Nasir Mahmood. Marja Aziz. Shah Mohammed Abdul Aziz. Chaudhry Aziz Al Rahman. Kandan Bandili. Roji Baliming. Vijay Kumar Reddy Bandar. Mohammed Nayabul Bali. Mr. Monar Begain. Ayman Ben Ali. Mohammed Wakat Bhatti. Mohammed Mosuzumin Buyua. Alessandro Bilocci. Gangahara Rao Badul. Gangandeep Kal Bara. Julina Brago. Sita Kumari Bajari. Umair Bhatt. Animesh Chakrabarti. Adib Shahidi. Furqan Ahmed. Devmata Shendenhall. Mohammed Shakis Shishmui. Mohammed Imitis Kabir Chaudhry. Rafael Cortez. Manuel Junior Payas Khalil. William Gilbert de Sousa. Gaya Fanfia Priya Dagalamuma Dagalamuma Arashiji. Asman Rashid Dar. Ram Sharan Dakal. Elizabeth Dale. Lucas Adekunle Durajaji. Ellis Ararumba Enobakari. Sushitra Rani Datta. Safafet Atab Fahim. Amber Fayaz. Kieran Fayaz. Nimela Suwia Ferdinand. Rosemary Fawkes. Atul Kanatala Gatiwad. Sarok Giri. Francis Gomez. Paramesh Boini. Shahib Ahmed Riyad. Rana Lina Midat. Hamad Noshasharan Raja. Suraj Faidan. Satyabratha Taladulka Sabir. Imtiaz Ahmed. Mohammed Abu Hanif. Roshana Badadur Hadawani. Mohammed Wasim Hayafez. Mohammed Ghulam Hazif.